Hi, I'm Gary and I'm a MailChimp Pro partner. In this short video, I'll show how we can identify which domains may be having issues with our emails sent from MailChimp. So I get contacted often by people saying, my emails sent from MailChimp, for example, are getting caught up in Gmail. They're going to the promotions tab and people aren't opening the emails. And I say to them, but how do you actually know it's Gmail? And they say, well, someone told me that had Gmail, and so on. But there's no definitive or quantitative proof. But fortunately, in the reports, and very few people seem to know this, but in the MailChimp reports, we can identify domains that are either serving our needs well with high open and click rates, or those that aren't. Let me show you. Let's go across to MailChimp. Now, if you like this video, please subscribe to my YouTube channel, and please like this video. I'm in the report section of my demo MailChimp account at the moment, so we can identify how well receiving servers are performing by going into a report. So I'll click view report just for any sent campaign. So if you think that you're having certain problems delivering to Gmail and so on, this is the way you'd do it. You'd go into a report and then click Analytics 360. Now this Analytics 360 tab is typically used when you've connected up Google Analytics, but in this case, you don't need Google Analytics connected. It's just that most people don't know what this email domain performance does, and that's what we're going to concentrate on. So I'll now go to a MailChimp account with quite a lot of data under email domain performance to sort of just show what we can see there. So you'll notice here that there's various data here. So for this email account, it's sent mostly to gmail.com. So what this means here is these are the raw numbers, 32,394. So 32,394 emails were sent to that domain in this email, specific email campaign. So in this case, the audience was however many, you know, tens of thousands of people they sent to everyone. And this breaks it down for us. And it says we sent 32,394 to Gmail, which was 56 of all recipients or subscribers that we sent to from MailChimp. So 56 sent to Gmail, 17% to Hotmail, and so on. Now, Gmail is very typically the largest receiver. You know, it's a very popular email service. But what we're really interested in is opens and clicks. That's probably the most important thing for what we're demonstrating today. So what we can see, just going across, okay, so 56% of our emails were sent to Gmail domains, Gmail subscribers. 42% of Gmail subscribers, or those subscribers with a Gmail email address, 42% opened. That's very good. And 1% clicked. Okay, the click rate wasn't very high in this particular campaign. But then let's look at hotmail.com. So we sent 17% of our emails were sent there, but the open rate was far lower. Even though the numbers were fairly high, why on Gmail was there 42% open rate, but on Hotmail, only 29% open rate? Okay, 29% is still pretty good. But that indicates that there's something going on. You know, there might be something going on. Why is it so significantly higher, the open rate on Gmail? But clicks are fairly steady. So just sort of going down the line, we can see that yahoo.com.au performed very well, as did yahoo.com. Very high open rates. Same as bigpond.com, which is a free email service here in Australia, and so on. But if you were looking for any service to say, or any domain to say, is there a problem, it would be this Hotmail one in this case, particularly if it was lower than this. We'd look at it and go, okay, so why are only 29% or, you know, of Hotmail opening, where for the other services they're so much higher? Then we would research what is specifically Hotmail looking for. Maybe there were too many, well, there was not enough text, for example, in this particular email. Therefore, Hotmail, and Hotmail is, for some reason, known that they prefer more text rather than just images in your email. So maybe that's the issue. So we could change our email, design to look more, to have more text in it. Maybe the subject line was an issue, so we can test. We can do tests in those ways. But that's how we can identify which domains might be having issues with our emails and then troubleshoot it. But please like this video. My name is Gary.